Good evening. Thank you for allowing me to piggyback on Dr. Srikanth's presentation. Recently an interesting case of low platelet count, which you may not see very often, so I thought I'll share with you. So this is a 45-year-old female. Actually, just check some 2 to 3 minutes. 45-year-old female presented with them. Transient numbness and weakness of the right upper and lower limb. She had headache and she came to the emergency in Ramchandra Hospital, and because of the history, she was seen by the neurophysician and CT and MRI brain were normal, and she was diagnosed as DIA, and then a complete hemogram was done. And blood count shows severe thrombocytopenia with a platelet count of 8,000, hemoglobin was 7.5, and total count and differential count, I mean essentially, she had a sort of leukocytosis but no abnormal cells, and LDH was elevated. So in summary, she had anemia, low platelet count and elevated LDH and with TIA. So this clinical, peripheral smear is very classical. This actually gave the diagnosis. See this fragmented red cells. There are many fragmented red cells. See one here and one there. So this is a very typical presentation of microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, where you can have thrombocytopenia, and this is called a thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, TTP. So this is not ITP. That's the most important thing. And if you do not recognize it, it is a fatal disease. I mean, you need to intervene in a different way. You should not treat it with like an ITP. This lady had a classical neurological manifestation, high LDH, and the peripheral smear showed a fragmented red cell. So the moral is you should have a good facility to see a peripheral smear, which just costs about 200 to 300 rupees. I mean, whereas this, it's very difficult to do a good peripheral smear, but you can easily get a PET scan nowadays. So the diagnosis is TTP, thrombotic thrombocytic purpura. It's a condition which causes microangiopathy. Platelets are consumed. And the main reason for this is a high level of von Willebrand factor, because in the normal homeostasis, the von Willebrand factor gets cleaved by a von Willebrand factor cleaving enzyme. And if the cleaving enzyme is deficient, then the von Willebrand factor goes up. Then that leads to stickiness of the platelets. And that's the pathophysiology, it's an autoimmune condition. So the von Willebrand cleaving enzyme is attacked by the antibody. This is an antibody to the von Willebrand cleaving enzyme, what is called as ADAMTS13, and that's the enzyme's name. But you can do an assay of the ADAMTS13, which is not widely available even in the United States. So you should rely upon the classical features of thrombocytopenia, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia, where you see fragmented red cells, neurological symptoms, renal involvement can be there, fever. And the diagnosis is thrombocytopenia, red cell fragmentation, raised LDH. So the management is plasma exchange. So that's the main treatment, that's the key. And if it is not done, the patient will not improve and it could be fatal. And that's to be done daily. In some days, it can be done twice a day. And the platelet transfusion is actually contraindicated because it will add to the thrombosis. And this is how the plasma exchange is done. It is now the cell separator machine, and it takes out the patient's plasma and puts in a new plasma. That is, antibodies are removed and then it gets diluted by a fresh plasma. So this patient did really well with the plasma exchange therapy. You can see the hemoglobin going up and the platelet going up and the LDH falling, and it's a quite rewarding experience. We don't see that very often, but you may have to recognize it. And the main important investigation, for every case of thrombocytopenia, you should examine the peripheral smear very carefully. That's what we do. And before starting steroids, you should examine the peripheral smear, and that gives a lot of valuable information. Thank you very much.
Thank you.